Come on a hot summer date with me to the Dragon Boat Festival.
这是干什么的？这是叫龙水。
Where we shall enjoy a long table feast.
这个菜也是有意义，你看五谷丰登，寓意着这种生活美好的向往。
Race on a modern dragon boat, douse ourselves in dragon water, and take part in all kinds of local festivities.
这是美国制造的。So
come with me as I find out what a rural dragon water festival is all about. A healthy environment is the secret to longevity. Walking through the rural areas of Chiang Mai, you will often come across elderly villagers sitting under a tree, relaxing or chatting together. And you will always see smiles on their faces. Hainan's county of Chiang Mai can be found in the northwest of the island, adjacent to the provincial capital, Haikou. To the northwest of the small town of Jinjiang lies an historical village that goes by the name of Tuyen. According to the village chronicles, in the 48th year of Emperor Kangxi's reign, people moved here from various neighboring villages. It was then that Tuyen was officially established as a village, having now existed for more than 300 years.
Yan, welcome to Tuyen.
哇，你这个国际文化交流真的到位啊！哎，土堰这个名字哈很奇特的哈，是不是起的是因为这里的土很漂亮？
你猜对了，哎，就是因为土堰周边的红壤土非常漂亮又非常肥沃，因此得名土堰村。原来如此哈，咱们这个村有多少人呢？这个村有290多户，1100多人，主要是务农为主，在釜山地区是算比较大的村。哦。
With its crystal clear waters and lush green mountains, Tuyen is becoming ever more attractive.
哎，书记，我看咱们村的这个生态环境非常的好哈，咱们这儿是不是有很多百年的老树啊？没错，我们村的古树是非常多的，嗯，保存也非常完整，嗯，
比如说我们旁边的那个箭独木，大吧？
哦，好大，好壮观的，
这个有150岁以上。哇哦，然后。 树高大概有差不多30米。哇哦！但它的名字是什么毒？箭毒木。那这个名字听起来好可怕。这棵树是不是有毒？是有毒，它的树皮的枝叶是有毒的。嗯。然后还有一个学名，名字叫做箭血凤猴。The
bark cloth tree or upas tree, one of the Mauritius family, has grey bark and highly toxic sap. Despite this, it is highly prized.
古代村民，把树干的枝叶涂在那个弓箭上，拿弓箭来射杀猎物的。啊，就是狩猎用的。狩猎用的。啊，有意思。那它有药用价值，
树皮呢又可以纤维很多嘛，可以做被子。哦，真的？啊，对，是国家三级保护植物哦。哦，哇。According to villagers, six huge upas trees have been with them since their childhood.
您看。 猜猜这是什么？应该是一些果，不知道果实还是什么的。就是箭血凤猴的果实。就这个树的？对。笨哥，没事没事没事的。这个我们从小吃到大，它虽然树皮的枝叶有毒，但是果实是可以食用。The
edible fruit of the upas tree is called jia mao. For the locals, these fruits are symbols of the upas tree's richness.
这口感应该是蛮好的，很甜哦，这个特别甜，很甜，特别甜，有毒的树，嗯，还可以吃它，来来来，真的是有点，不可思议的哈，来，祝我好运，哇，这个口感，味道有点像香蕉，
对，
但是口感不同，很奇怪，刚才有点像肉，我第一印象是有点像肉。
Here I am eating the forbidden fruit from a poisonous tree and seemingly living to tell the tale. At least so far, so good. They're actually pretty tasty. Bathing in dragon water is among the unique dragon boat festival customs in Hainan, representing the wishes of the people for health and peace. During this year's dragon boat festival holiday, Tuyem is hosting a special ceremony called the Village Dragon Water Festival.Every year on the fifth day of the fifth month of the lunar calendar, the Chinese celebrate a traditional feast day known in English as the Dragon Boat Festival. Tuyen marks this occasion with some gusto, arranging as it does a series of activities. Now come with me for a closer look. The custom of drawing eyes on the dragon's head marks the opening of this year's Village Dragon Water Festival.The ritual of drawing eyes on the dragon's head involves someone dipping a brush into ink and drawing eyes on the auspicious beast. This is believed to bring good luck and prosperity to locals.The dragon is an age-old Chinese symbol which is highly revered by China's Han people who believe that the dragon will bring them good fortune.
舞龙点睛的仪式不仅表达了对美好生活、风调雨顺、幸福安康这个向往，还传达了积极向上、拼搏进取的这么一个精神。
哦，哇，那是一个非常美好的一个寓意哈。
对，一个传统的一个仪式，
挺好的。不。哎，哇，是干什么的？
来、哦、来来来来，
这是什么的？
这是艾草，
这是龙水，
这是叫龙水，
龙水
，
对。然后这是艾草，
艾草，
艾草也是一种中草药，
哦，
在这个民间呢，有这个驱蚊、解毒、解暑的这么一个功效，
哎，
比如说小孩子皮肤过敏了、可以泡水煮水来洗澡，
啊，挺好的。
端午就是节气中最热的一天，哦，所以呢。这个拿这个艾草来，这个
对呀，
这个、吉祥的意义。
For Chinese people, Asiatic wormwood plays a pivotal role in the Dragon Boat Festival, having gradually become an all-important component of their daily lives.
Ian，你知道艾草长什么样子吗？
哎，我真不知道哎，怎么样？
大概就是五六十公分高
啊，
然后叶子是青绿色的，呈锯齿状。
OK，
闻起来有淡淡的香味。
听起来很有特色哈、
对，村里面藏了不少，活动不是 DIY 植物拓印吗、
哦、
主题就是艾草叶拓印，您可以去找找，
那你带我去吧走。Tuyen is full of greenery, making it a far from easy task to locate the wormwood.
哎，阿公你好，我想问一下，这个艾草在哪里有
啊？这里啊，
这里是不是？
啊，是啊。
哦，就这个尖尖的那个，
就是个尖尖。
它本来在这儿呢。哦，谢谢，等，那我去采一点啊。好，好，哎呦，有，好，我怎么把呢？就直接飘这样子吧，就直接就这样子拔出来。哎呦，哎呦，整个根也出来了，好香
啊，香啊。
好好，谢谢，端午节安康。
哎，
好好好，谢谢。哎，书记啊，这是不是？
你很厉害哦，对，就
是我厉害，咋厉害？
就是了，
你还厉害？
哎，不，哎呀，太棒了！来，我们去做一个探阴了。
好，
走。
A plant rubbing is basically the same as a traditional rubbing. Both use a rubbing method to record a piece of art.
一般来说，一般的探阴就是用纸在石碑上，把石碑上的字还有画临摹下来。但是我们做了创新，植物探阴呢？就是这个用植物平铺在纸布上，
哎，
把它的形状给印出来。因为艾草它本身的枝叶是含有颜料，
就是说它的色素会出来，然后渗到这个布料里面去，然后留一个影子那种，是吧？
哦，没错。
To do a plant rubbing, you need first to arrange the wormwood into an aesthetically pleasing shape. Then secure it to the cloth with sticky tape and begin to crush the wormwood with a small, smooth stone. The wormwood juice seeps into the cloth, creating a natural silhouette.
This is going to wear me out because there's only one leaf I've done so far. 这够吗？好。 哎，这是什么呢？
这是蘸蘸颜料啊，印上去
啊，等于一个印章哈，是吧？
对对对。
OK， red paint， 就擦得均匀哈。啊，
写在字上，涂在字上啊，可以了。
OK
OK，
那我就印上去。
印上去。
OK， are you ready？ Are you ready？这个用不用？
不用，
不用，
不用。
Let's have a look.
漂亮！漂亮
OK. Oh, look at this. Well, this is a fun and educational little exercise. Participants can learn something about how to do a traditional Chinese rubbing, while deepening their knowledge and understanding of plant life.The Chinese often say that people respect food as they do heaven. During the Dragon Boat Festival, everyone prepares cuisine unique to this occasion. Well, after searching for wormwood all morning, I'm now absolutely famished. And here by the lake, I can see what looks a bit like a buffet taking shape. So let's go and see whether I can pilfer anything tasty.
饿了吗？
饿了，饿了。
还有重头戏。今天中午的长桌宴。是今天活动的重头戏，
很大。
然后今天的长桌宴呢，有100米长。
不会吧？
对，
这么长。
50桌，
那肯定也有很多好吃的哈。
来品尝一下美食，
走。耶！哎呦，哇，这么多菜，全是我的吗？
一起享用。
好。
您看看今天我们举办的这个长桌宴呢，是有意义的。
哦，有什么意义呢？
长长久久，国泰民安。
有这么一个含义啊，
对对对，
很深刻的。On this 100 meter long table, villagers of Tuyen have put on a lovely spread of their carefully prepared local delicacies. I cannot wait to taste them. 他们跟端午节有什么关系？
给你介绍菜系
吧。可以可以可以。
粽子啊，端午节必须要吃的。
必须的啊，
这个呢，海南粉，海南腌粉，农村走地鸡，稻田鸭。还有盐水豆腐，都是这个村的土特产，村民自种自养的。你尝一下粽子，今天是端午节，必须要吃粽子。
对，这个不可少的哈。来，喂，
有蛋有肉。
哎，我拿一块，哎，你看，哇 ，an egg and pork rice ball。好好吃，很香的。
Every dish is packed with the sincerest wishes of Tuyen's villagers.
为什么会这样子摆盘子呢？
圆盘，圆圆满满，这个菜也是有意义。你看五谷丰登，寓意着这生活美好的向往。
而且你们放这些叶子哈，就是原生态的感觉。
就是，一个是为了好看，一个卫生，而且它这些叶子有天然的香气，会提升菜品的香气。
是，就这样。祝你端午节安康。
端午安康。Cheers.
Cheers.
After satisfying my taste buds, some music would be just the thing. A summer concert staged here in Tuyen conveys villagers' enthusiasm to visitors from far and near.
Sitting here relaxing in the shade, being serenaded on the one hand by a chorus of cicadas and a live band on the stage is a satisfying sensation indeed, and one that I would highly recommend.
Tuyen is surrounded by mountains on one side and water on its other three. The small lake at the entrance to the village serves as the venue for the day's dragon boat racing.
Well, despite the heat at this time of year being nothing short of searing, the enthusiasm of the boaters has not been dampened at all. And as you can see, their supporters are out in full force here to cheer them on. Dayo!
Yeah. 你听说过赛龙舟吗？
那当然了。 每年的端午节就是不同的队伍会赛，对吧？坐在那个赛龙舟的上面，完了还有一个人在那跳舞哈，对吧？鼓励他们，
没错。
那为什么每年都要赛这个赛龙舟呢？
它有一个起源，据说是因为纪念屈原，世人屈原投江，然后呢，当地的老百姓为了怀念他，不让这些鱼虾把他的尸体给吃掉，所以就拼命的划去抢救他的尸体。
Dragon boat racing is one of the customs of the Dragon Boat Festival and one of the most important activities of the day. Kuyen's Dragon Water Festival not only incorporates local folk culture, but with the addition of some fun games.
传统的节端午节呢，就是很漂亮的长洲，有许多的选手在上面，然后有敲锣打鼓，
对，
竞技比赛，
对，
传统的。
非常激烈的，
这次不同，
好，
结合我们这次的这个乡村这个主题的活动，为了更接地气，为更便利的游玩，所以我们就把这个龙舟改成这种像划小船的这么一种娱乐的形式，让大家更容易体验一些。
那挺好的，这样就是更多的人都可以参与进来哈。
对，
这个脚哦。Okay, wish me luck. Here I go.哎呦，就屁股
啊，
屁股哦，
屁股对
对，还是有点湿，
可以，没事吧？
还好。Okay, easy.
Let's go.
Okay, let's go. 说完，
结
束了。哦，这么快的？好吧。Well, I love this modern take on the traditional dragon boat race. It's a lot less intense and a lot more accessible than the traditional variety. Sadly, though, today I only had third place. Still, I'm quite happy with that. Who knows? Maybe next year I'll get gold.
For the people of Hainan, the Dragon Boat Festival does not just mean eating rice dumplings or racing dragon boats. More important than that is the obligatory sacred ritual of bathing in dragon water.
In the Chronicles of Yazhou, there is a reference to dragon water, which has its roots in Hainan. Now here in Tuyen, it is pulling in the punters who are all coming to take part in this mysterious age-old practice. Come with me if you're game.
People believe that on the day of the Dragon Boat Festival, the dragon descends from the sky to play in the water, which subsequently becomes dragon water. Dousing yourself in dragon water brings you protection and ensures you stay healthy and safe for the whole year.
Well, although thoroughly drenched from head to toe, everyone is, as you can see, as happy as can be. This is certainly a novel and refreshing way to enjoy local culture. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have some revenge to take.
Market has attracted many villagers, and from the early morning, it is packed with curious tourists.
说起这里正热闹哈、啊，
是啊，这是我们的乡村集市哦，都是本村的土特产。比方说，哎，这个挺有特色的，鸭子粽子。
哦，哇哦，是个粽子啊！
对对对，一个粽子，
但是是小鸟的这个形状、啊，
鸭子的形状。
哦，鸭子，
这个家里有小孩子呢，就包这种粽子，然后可以玩，可以看、然后就可以吃。
Most of the items sold at the market are handmade by the villagers. Every type of handicraft and every snack all represent their sincerity.
这个是什么？
这个糕，这糕是米粉。 还有这个植物的枝叶来制作的。
哦，在融合在一起。
对，它有降暑，然后小孩子吃了呢能打干虫，啊、有寄生虫在底下它可以排出来，
还有药用
药效功能。
OK OK。哇，那是多方面的用途哈。那个呢，是不是有点像一瓜？
对，一瓜
啊，一瓜
糍粑，哎，
一瓜我的最爱，
都是农民自己。
来，
哎，尝个吧。
谢谢。谢谢。你自己还是一瓜啊？哎，海南的特产最棒的，谢谢大家啊。哦，
好了，嗯，
美味的很。Well, I've had a couple of iguas before as well, but.Eating it in this atmosphere, a carnival atmosphere, it's very different indeed and makes it all the more fun.
Nowadays, the Dragon Boat Festival has become an opportunity for everyone to have a midsummer reunion.On this day, everyone eats rice dumplings, bathes in dragon water, and passes on words of blessing to each other to express their best wishes for good health and happiness.
Spending the Dragon Festival here in Tuyen has been a unique experience. Not only have I come away with my own artwork, I've been able to join in these lively festivities while learning more about China's culture. With each passing year, this traditional celebration is taking on more newand innovative forms.
This is 海南卫视